We've met Elder John and Jill through the MIT ministry. Elder John was the teacher's assistant, and many times he covered us. He made sure that we didn't get smoked. Other times he just put us in arm's way and he allowed us to get smoked.
I've met John down at his father's church. Bishop had a preaching engagement down there, and I encountered him and his wife, but I really became friends going through EIT class with Levi. It was the three amigos, and we all graduated, or we were all ordained at the same time.
Well, I met Elder John and Jillian. Well, we met Elder John and Jillian about, I don't know, a few years ago at my brother's house for Thanksgiving. And Jillian, she brought over this lovely dessert. It was in this big container. And, you know, I love food, he loves food, and it was history after then. Then a few years later, they joined the church, and we have known them ever since.
My first time really remembering Elder John was when I was a college student at Yale. We used to come up during the summers, and when we were off in class, and we would come to New Vision. I just remember seeing him play the pianos and thinking, this guy looks like the actor from Daddy's Little Girls, Idris Elba. I think he has a resemblance, and that's the first thing, I'm just being honest, the first thing I remember. And then I remember him preaching, and I remember him preaching about Jonah, and then I remember one time he preached about Lazarus. And this was years ago, and he had Elder Levi come out wrapped up totally and completely. And I just remember that visual. So those were my first memories of Elder John.
And then there were times when he just stripped us of everything and left us naked, and we got smoked yet again. Sister Jill was part of our ministry. She was at MIT, and so she pretty much got smoked along with us.
I just want to thank John and Jill for keeping me out of jail. I know orange is the new black, but I really don't look good in that color. I will miss you both.
Jill, I thank you for always just making me feel like the most special girl in the world. The conversations that you have with me, I just love you. I thank you for your gift of jewelry that you shared with me.
Yes, I would like to tell John and Jill they will definitely be missed. Their ministry, their love, their encouragement, all that they've shown me from the time I entered New Vision until now.
John and Jill, I'm going to miss you so much, but I understand that you have to go. Thank you for all the encouragement, everything that you imparted. John, thank you for all your prayers and your encouragement, even the smokings when I was dragging onto the stage for the praise team. Jill, I want to thank you for all the times that you threw me the notes during the songs and threw me the lyrics when I didn't know what was going on. You guys mean so much. You're just a mainstay in this ministry, and I just can't imagine how it's going to be without you. I love you, and please stay in touch.
And thanks for the earrings. These are actually yours. You are gifted, and I'm waiting to see jewelry go forward, your book for marriage and ministry go forward. Open doors. You're just going to blow us away on what God's going to do for you in Atlanta. So continue to do all that you're doing, and I love both of you with all my heart. You are blessed.
And I really got to know Jillian in the latter years when we came back around 2009 and we started to get connected in New Vision. She's such a sweet, sweet lady. And who could forget that accent? And she has this wonderful way of lovingly telling you the truth, especially when it comes to marriage and date night. And Jillian, Lindsay, and I remember everything that you told us, and we are working diligently to apply it.
Ooh, you guys are gonna take that midnight train to Georgia. That's that's a big step, major step. We know it's a divine step, a God step. I remember when they told us that they were gonna do this, and they weren't sure whether or not, you know, this is the right season or the right time. And God opened up doors for them immediately, you know, in the midst of some situations that we know about that shouldn't have been open, but they opened them anyway, and it had to be God. And so we're praying God's blessing and anointing as a spiritual father. We pray a release over everything that he puts his hand to, everything his wife puts his hand to, that his family will be blessed, and that Atlanta for them, I talked to John today, and it's just like it would represent the promised land for him.
Well, John, Elder John, and Jillian, you have been an exceptional leaders. You both are funny, you're sincere, you're amazing people, you are committed, you love the Lord with all your heart. Jillian, you have an amazing talent with jewelry, as you see. Jewelry! You all would sorely be missed. You know, it's a good thing.
They really will be.
You really will be missed. It's a great thing when you can leave a ministry and people shed tears, and your presence will be missed, you know. So you all have come, you've worked, you've labored, and now God has elevated you, and He's moving you out to bigger and better. And when you all make it and the Lord really puts you before the world, don't forget us.
When you enter your kingdom.
We love you so much.
We just pray that the blessings of God would just overtake you, and that you would just come into a place that you never thought that you could come into. We love you.
See,
I'm you.
Oh, I'm sorry. I
go ahead.
Got over your words. See, I'm just laughing right now, but you know, inside I am crying. You guys are like our best friends. We love you. We love your family, the kids. You know, so many years we grew up, even before New Vision. We were friends. God bless you and your family down in ATL, and we will see you soon.
This is my girl Bonnie McKeithen.
This is my girl Mary Winston.
And we're here to say farewell to the Wilkinson family.
Farewell, guys.
Bye.
We love you. We're going to miss you so very much.
We are. We love you guys. We love your children.
Our second child.
Oh, yes, our second son, you know, from another mother and another father,
of course,
you know.
Mm-hmm.
Ayana, also, your beautiful smiling face. We're going to miss you.
Grown into such a lovely young
beautiful
lady.
Young lady.
Absolutely.
Yes. But we know that God has big plans for you all. With big plans for you all. And we know that this isn't really farewell. It's just so long for now.
Yes, only for now.
Well, one of the ways that I think that me and Jill became more like sister brothers was while me and John was going through the EIT training, she would encourage us. Of course, she would come and talk to me, encourage me. You know, her and my wife would hang out a little bit, and so our relationship grew.
Elder John and Jillian, you guys are such a delightful couple. I will miss you dearly. I know my wife Lindsay will miss you dearly. You guys are a breath of fresh air, and I know that God has great plans in store for you. So move with boldness and power. This next season of your life is going to be tremendous. You have each other, you have your kids, and you have the favor of God. So go forth and do mighty things. We look forward to seeing the updates. And because I know both of you are on Facebook, I know we're gonna see the updates as well. We love you. We're gonna miss you, but we know we gotta let you go.
I just wanna say to the Wilkinsons that I love you dearly, that you will be missed from the bottom of my heart. I love just the special gift that you guys are as a couple, and how you teach and pour into other couples. Thank you so much.
Farewell. Take off to ATL. And I just want to wish the best for both of you. I just want to say I love the both of you. I enjoy worshiping with the both of you.
Hi, Mr. John and Sammy. I wrote to speak because, you know, I don't like public speaking and to be put on the spot. And as Anna stated, great men and women are not awarded or rewarded most times until they pass on. But I want to tell you about my motivator, my hero, my mentor, my father, and my friend, Mr. John. Mr. John came into my life when I needed someone to help me. He motivated me to be the person I am today. He helped me to be more aware of greatness, hard work, discernment, perseverance, patience, and tolerance. Mr. John also helped me to build my self-esteem and taught me how to be more well-rounded individual. I met Mr. John at the Health Career Academy, and from there we stayed connected. All my achievements, he played a vital role in. Mr. John, I love and respect you for everything that you have done for me. And I will always remember you as a father away from home. Thank you for being my friend. Continue helping people like me. You make the world a better place. I love you.
Your presence will greatly be missed. You know, we can't feel them nice shoes you used to wear, you know, the pointy joints and all that. You know, nobody had that swagger like you, John. But the two of you together, there's nothing that you can't do. So, you know, God has you, God is moving you. Just stay in the flow with what the Lord is doing, and you don't have to worry about nothing.
Come on, somebody.
Can I get an amen?
Come on, somebody.
I'm preaching better than y'all responding.
Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
you can do it. You can. Come on, come on. Come on, somebody. Tell your neighbor that you can do it. You can. And God got a blessing for you. I just felt that right now.
Okay, DJ.
Oh, DJ?
Yeah.
Okay.
Come on, somebody.
Come on, somebody.
Hey, come on,
it's
somebody.
Right, it's right.
Yes, it is. Yes. Hallelujah.
God's got a blessing for you. My British accent is not as well as it should be right now.
You can't do that. I'm just saying. You can't. I'm just saying.
I remember times in my office I would ask John a question or he would get smoked. And John would go, Pastor, I don't get called. Oh. That's my best interpretation of John. Those eyes closed and used to kill me, man.
Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody.
Come on, somebody.
Come on now, somebody. You know. What's up, man? You know, God is doing good, man. He's working. Yeah, man. No, yeah. All right. No, man. God's doing good. Amen. Hey, what's up, boss? No. God, yes, sir. Yes.
Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. And he preaches hard. Y'all ain't listen. Y'all. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Postmodernism. Humanism. Come on. These are the things that they're going through. And what is the church doing? Come on, somebody.
Don't talk in her neck.
Hey everybody, I'm Bishop Derek L. Calhoun, and this is...
Lady Sharon. What is this is stuff?
This is.
Really?
Praise team. Thank you for...
You know what?
Oh, that was a good flow! You done messed her up!
You all hunched up, and my name is Bishop Derek L. Calhoun.
Yeah. That is Tony making fun of, I'm not gonna say any names, Tony, his dad, making fun of his father.
You need to be ready to receive. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody.
We are truly going to miss you. I feel like that is horrible. I'm sorry. That was like.
You do. You're telling me where to go. You're like grabbing this and saying go. You don't do that.
To go away, and when your time was spent, you did all you could to prove you had.